It is my pleasure to welcome you to the 19th commencement ceremony for Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School. Please rise for our national anthem and opening prayer. Emma Sheehan, senior member of the Peer Ministry Group, will sing the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets regard, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
at this time, I would like to ask Father Jadot, our chaplain, to lead us in prayer.
Good evening. Welcome to our graduation of class 2020. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Lord God, as we gather this evening to celebrate, to honor our seniors, class of 2020, we thank you for the gift of life, thank you for the gift of families, thank you for the gift of Catholic education. Today we ask your blessings upon these students, our seniors. May you continue to guide them, to watch over them, to protect them as they continue the journey toward our higher educations. We thank you for the 4 years they have spent with us here at Archbishop McCarthy, for all the blessings you have granted upon them during the past 4 years. Continue to provide for them, continue to watch over them so that they can succeed in life and contribute to make a difference in the world. We ask this in Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I would like to introduce Mr. Richard P. Jean, our principal, to give the principal's address.
Good evening, parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, friends, and especially to the class of 2020. And also, I'd like to have a special thanks to the incredible, wonderful staff that I have at Archbishop McCarthy, staff and teachers. You know, this year we went through the transition without a hiccup, and I would love to take this moment to say thank you to all of the wonderful people at McCarthy that have made this year possible. Thank you. Here we are, graduation finally. And I know this is not the perfect situation, but this is the safest situation in the circumstance that we're in. And sometimes in life, we learn that we are not in control. And anybody who knows me know that I am a control freak. Very quietly, but I am. But today, we're here to celebrate all the great things that you've accomplished. And we're gonna talk about all those things, because that's what it's all about today, is about you, the class of 2020. Do you remember this day? This is the day I received an email from the Archdiocese saying that we're going on online learning until April 13th. But here we are, still in online learning. So I do understand how disappointing things can be when you are not in control. Because at this time, I'm truly not in control. As of right now, I can tell you, I don't know what's gonna happen for the start of the school year. Will we be still online, or will we be back to regular school, or will we be into the new normal? I don't know. But this is where we have to let God take over and let Him be in control. Yes, we are not in control. I need you to do me a favor, because as humans, we tend to sometimes just focus on the negative. Don't focus on just the last 9 weeks, because you have to remember, your high school career is 144 weeks, and you've done great things. You have enjoyed McCarthy. You have achieved greatness in academics, the activities, the sports, the arts. So please don't. Think of all the great memories you've had from Maverick games, the retreats, the carnival, the football games. That's what you want to remember. And we still have a lot more memories to go that we're going to make. Well, hopefully the theme parks will start opening up and we'll be able to vote on a part I want, even water park. I'm okay. Because we want to be able to spend the day with you guys. Because you didn't have grad bash, we can have a grad day. So we can meet up there. I don't know what the laws are when it comes to transporting now, but however we can meet at a park and spend another day together as a class. And there's still more memories. We can get together, let's brainstorm, let's create committees, students, that we could get together and look at how can we put a prom together. Could it be we could call it a reunion? I don't mind. We could have, you know, the graduation on our campus, on the field. But when the regulations open up and we're safe. You've been here for 4 years. One thing anybody will tell you, that I am very safety conscious. I'm not going to change that. We will do it when it's safe to make sure that everybody, from the students to the parents to the visitors, will be safe. Class of 2020, please do me a favor as your principal. Don't waste this crisis. Continue to become a better student, a better person, a better Christian. Right now, we don't know what's going to happen in the fall. What's going to happen with the universities? If it's going to be online or in person. But can I tell you something? You're going to be prepared better than anybody. Why? You've been using Canvas for the last 4 years. You know it probably better than us. And now, you've had 4 weeks of Zoom. That is what universities use. You are going to dominate. So no matter what, you're already ahead. Because we know we prepared you academically. Technology-wise, you will dominate. And we're going to see more and more technology. That's what this crisis has brought. More technology is going to be added into our world. But you are prepared. So that sense, you don't need to worry. Now, I need to tell you something. You have to remember, and I mentioned this throughout my speech several times. In life, sometimes we are not in control, and it's okay. And I hope in the last 4 years at McCarthy, you have created a relationship with Jesus Christ, which is going to allow you to be able to say, let God take care of this.
The Archbishop McCarthy High School Salutatorian has many outstanding achievements. This student has the distinguished honor of being a National Merit Commended Scholar and a National Hispanic Scholar, along with being an AP scholar with distinction, an Excelsior scholar, and a Silver Cord recipient for community service. She is a member of the National Honor Society, Mu Alpha Theta, and the National English, Science, Social Studies, and Robotics Honor Societies. She was also a member of Peer Ministry, the Faith in Action Today Club, the Women's Varsity Volleyball Team, and volunteered as a summer camp counselor at His House Children's Home. This student received the George Eastman Young Leaders Award from the University of Rochester for outstanding academic achievement and leadership. She was accepted to Columbia University, the University of Florida, the University of Chicago, California Institute of Technology, Carnegie Mellon, Georgia Institute of Technology, and the University of Central Florida. After much deliberation, she has decided to attend California Institute of Technology with the career goal of becoming a computer scientist or a software engineer. It is an honor to introduce Gabriella Twombly.
Greetings, parents, faculty, family members, and my fellow students. Congratulations to the class of 2020. I am honored and humbled to be here with you today as your class salutatorian. Since I cannot actually see you, I hope that you can feel the love and appreciation that I have in my heart for each and every one of you. I would like to start by expressing a sincere and collective thank you to all of the teachers, coaches, clergy, staff, and administration at Archbishop McCarthy. You have all played a vital role in helping each of us grow in both mind and spirit. In the words of Henry Adams, a teacher affects eternity. He or she can never tell where their influence will stop. Your influence and dedication to us, your students, is what moves the world and humanity forward. I want to also say thank you to our parents and guardians who have sacrificed, supported, encouraged, and motivated us to reach this point in our lives, graduation. Can you even believe it went by so fast? It seems like only yesterday we were learning to walk, talk, ride a bike, drive a car. Now as young adults, we are starting to prepare to head out into the world on our own. I myself am excited to head across the country to attend the California Institute of Technology in Pasadena, California, better known as Caltech, where I plan to pursue a degree in computer science. I couldn't have done this without the support from my mom, dad, sister, dog, and even Coach Frank. If someone had told me freshman year that I would be graduating in the middle of a worldwide health pandemic, I would have laughed. As I stand before you today, I am certain that none of us could have imagined a world with social distancing rules, stay-at-home orders, no proms, no senior nights, and virtual graduations. You have every right to be frustrated at missing those milestones, and yet you still manage to share your happiness and creativity with those around you. Jeremiah 29, verses 11 through 13. For I know the plans I have for you. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. In those days when you pray, I will listen. If you look for me wholeheartedly, you will find me. In an uncertain world, we can look back on the wonderful memories we've made during our high school experience that started with us as nervous freshmen. Shout out to our consecutive wins for best hallway decorating and Mav game dances. Congrats to our many district, regional, and state championships. And yes, that includes robotics. A big thanks to Mavzu for being the best in the hype game. I'm sure we'll miss homecomings, retreats, Kahoots, and Father Judot's masses. I, for one, know that I'll miss taking my McCarthy Bowls to class with me because the lines to get them were always that long. Sorry to Miss Ferrier and Mr. Sando for eating in class. And last but not least, we'll miss seeing our friends in class and talking to them in the parking lot after school. As you move on to college, there are some things I'd like you to remember. At times, life can feel like a rat race, where everyone is rushing to get somewhere or to reach a certain goal. I know many of us right now may not know exactly what they want to do or what their future holds. I assure you that most people have no idea what they're doing either. You may doubt yourself and your abilities at some point and forget why you even started. But we, class of 2020, are the future. We have the chance to use our special gifts to make a positive change in our society. I have absolutely no doubt you can achieve whatever you set your mind to. Whatever life throws at us, the class of 2020 is ready. We finish what we start. I'm blessed to have been able to spend the last 4 years with you, Mavericks. This is not a goodbye, only a see you soon. But I guess you can say that we've got the horses in the back. Good luck to one of the best graduating classes to ever grace McCarthy's halls. I love you, and God bless.
The Archbishop McCarthy High School valedictorian has many impressive accomplishments. He has the distinguished honor of being a National Hispanic Scholar, an Excelsior Scholar, and a Neubauer Scholar. He was the recipient of the Tufts University Neubauer Scholarship, which is offered to a select group of incoming students who demonstrate exceptional academic and personal promise. This student is a member of the National Honor Society and the Speech and Debate, Quill and Scroll, and Social Studies Honor Societies. His other accomplishments include being a student ambassador, a member of the STEM team and the Help Club, a morning anchor for MAV News, and a writer for the school's AMP magazine. He volunteered at the Schott Community Center and as part of the Best Buddies Club. He has been accepted at Tufts University, the University of Michigan, and the University of Central Florida. He will be attending Tufts University Neubauer Scholar Program with the goal of becoming a professor of biopsychology. It is an honor to introduce Bruce Demos.
Well, Mavericks of 2020, we've done it. We're graduating. We've turned 4 years, 16 quarters, and way too many standardized tests into memories. It's been the time of my life making Archbishop McCarthy a second home with all of you. And those memories we've made can't be taken away by changed plans and the unexpected, because they've made us who we are, and that's unforgettable. We could look back and meander down memory lane grade by grade, but to me, the sweetest moments were the little things sprinkled throughout. Let's be honest, high school was kind of chaotic. We start off with new friends and new classes and sport tryouts and picking clubs, but it's all been so worthwhile, because we have moments like getting ready for MAV games, hoping Mrs. Calder's ferrets would crawl inside my backpack, rushing in line for the McCarthy Bowl so I wouldn't get trampled, and having friends who would be there for me when it got rough. Even though our memories will vary, they're just as important to who we're becoming. I know these past 2 months, a lot of plans were replaced with confusion and maybe loneliness. But this time of difficulty doesn't mean all those other wonderful moments are gone, or that the memories ahead have been locked away. They're still there, and in the end, We are graduating because we've overcome our challenges. We gave our all at every game, crammed as hard as we could cram, and helped out friends when they needed us. Every lovely memory with teachers, friends, family, and even alone in the toughest of times will stick with us. I think William Wordsworth put it better than I ever could. Though nothing can bring back the hour of splendor in the grass, of glory in the flower, we will grieve not. Rather find strength in what remains behind. And boy, do we have a lot ahead of us. The friends I've met at Archbishop are some of the most passionate, talented, and caring people I've ever met. In the years ahead, your potential will be channeled into research, activism, the arts, and the betterment of life. I've met future veterinarians, doctors, engineers, artists, and leaders. No matter what lies ahead, I'm confident that with the tools we've earned these past 4 years, we'll be prepared to transform the world around us. And I can't wait to hear about all the amazing things you have yet to do. Whatever you do, though, don't forget about the people you love. I've spent 4 years preparing for exams, and yet it took until a quarantine for me to connect with my brothers. This summer is an opportunity for us to realize how much the people in our lives matter. Those with us, and those we wait to see. I know it's a serious thing to talk about, but don't be afraid as you grow in the years ahead to call your family to catch up with old friends, and to not miss out on new connections. Memories, really, are defined by those we share them with, so cherish them. With that in mind, to my mom, my dad, my Grammy, my brothers, I love you. This wouldn't have been possible without you. Thank you for the memories. To the teachers who supported us and challenged us, thank you for all the memories. To the friends I made and all the other wonderful people graduating today, thank you for all the memories. When you're off doing great things, use the lessons, the feelings, the love you felt these 4 years to remind yourself of how beautiful life can be. These 4 years were just the beginning, but boy, were they a lovely start. Best of luck, Mavericks. You've got this.
The following awards recognize the top student in each department. Each recipient was the highest performing student in the department throughout their 4 years at McCarthy. Please note, the valedictorian and salutatorian are not eligible for these awards. For the Business and Technology Department, Mr. Claude Rowland, Chairperson. This recipient will be attending the University of Central Florida and would like to obtain a position in the computer engineering industry. The recipient is Arturo Lara. The English Department, Mrs. Faith Grossi, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending the University of Central Florida and plans to study zoology as part of the pre-veterinary tract. The recipient is Sophia Weintraub. Fine Arts Department, Ms. Robin Gleason, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending Nova Southeastern University and plans to go into criminal justice and federal law enforcement. The recipient is Florian Huck. Mathematics Department, Ms. Jean Ferrier, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending Carnegie Mellon University and plans to pursue a career in the field of computer science. The recipient is Gabriel Zaragoza. The Physical Education Department, Mrs. Michelle Lovett, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending the University of Florida and plans to major in environmental studies and then go into law. The recipient is Valentina Carrion. The Science Department, Mr. Stephen Hanrahan, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending the University of Florida and plans to major in biology on the pre-med track. The recipient is Miguel Palacios. The Social Studies Department, Mr. Patrick Sando, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending the University of Florida and study business with a concentration in fashion merchandising. The recipient is Sofia Enriquez. Theology, Mr. Christopher Cavone, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University and plans to pursue a degree in meteorology. The recipient is Carlos Solares. World Languages Department, Ms. Camille Henderson, Chairperson. The recipient will be attending Washington University, St. Louis to study English education and plans to teach at the college level. The recipient is Anna Nunez. Now I will present the Guidance Award. Mrs. Terry Tribble, Director of College Advisement. The Archbishop McCarthy High School Guidance Award is given to the senior who earned the largest amount of scholarship money. This year's recipient has earned almost a total of $2,058,888 in scholarships. This student received the National Bonner Leadership Scholarship Award from Averitt University, which she will be attending. This is an intensive four-year community leadership opportunity committed to the belief that students can address critical social issues. The recipient is Valerie Serviveo. As of this date, the class of 2020 has received more than 28,464,287 in scholarship money. I would now like to make the presentation of the Archbishop's Leadership Award. The recipient is selected by members of the Theology Department and the administration of Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy Catholic School. The criteria for selection include the student's leadership in the study of theology, performance of Christian service, and school and community involvement. This year's honoree has been described as a person of devout faith, a role model of compassion and humility, a Catholic who lives his faith with exuberance. Our honoree is a Respect Life Club officer and was active in the Junior Peer Ministry program. He served at St. Mark Catholic Church, where he was co-catechist as part of the Religious Education Department and was involved in the youth ministry program and the choir. He also volunteered at the Marianitas Sisters in Miami and as an assistant coach for the St. Mark Girls JV basketball team. He lives the Catholic Christian values that are at the core of the mission of Archbishop McCarthy High School. He calls and inspires each of us to be the hands, the arms, the head, and the face of Jesus for others. On behalf of His Excellence, Thomas Wenske, Archbishop of Miami, and the entire Archbishop McCarthy High School family, it is my privilege to present the 2020 Archbishop's Leadership Award to Ian Lynch. This next award is given to students whose lives follow the mission of our mentor and namesake, Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy. This year, we have a group of students receiving the award. Our recipients are exceptionally motivated students who display admirable qualities in school and beyond. I am honored to present this award to the senior members of the women's soccer team, Emma Alfonso, Lauren Alvarino, Riley Bowser, Nadia Colon, Sofia Enriquez, Kelly Hastings, Cassandra Lawson, Natalia Perez, Jordan Pitter, Eliana Ramirez, Riley Schmel, and Megan Circle.
Wow, congratulations. Each year I go over the four A's: atmosphere, academics, athletics, and the arts. But this year I wanted to do something a little different. I've been talking a lot, so I wanted to get some other people to join in, especially since I know a lot of people wanted to speak to you, class of 2020. So I hope that you like the people I picked, but I think you will.
On behalf of the Board of Limited Jurisdiction, the faculty, and the administration, it is my privilege to present the seniors of the graduating class of 2020 of Archbishop McCarthy High School. Let us begin. Kevin Abreu, Daniel Acevedo, M-
Manuel Acosta. Nicholas Aguiar. Robert Aguilar. Bradley Alcime. Emma Alfonso. Michael Alfonso. Aaliyah Alpizar. Danielle Alpizar. D'Angela Alvarado. Daniela Álvarez Quintero. Lauren Alvarino. Jenna Amaro. Andrea Angel Trigueros. Nicholas Anon. Abraham Anthopan. Chelsea Anthopan. Marisa Arellano. Juan Aristizabal. Ángel Armesto. Brandon Arnold. Fiorella Badur. Riley Balzer. Sophia Bamford. Austin Barbaris. Adam Barros. Raiden Bartlett. Prajay Basnayet. Gabriela Battaglia. Mia Battle. Stefan Bufis. Michelle Benoit. Kaya Bentil. Ava Berchtold. Andrew Berksveinsen. Matthias Bernardini. Juan Betancourt. Jack Bialzak. Carolina Blanco. Nicholas Blasquez. Vanessa Bonnet. Nicholas Boyd. Nicole Brandon. Jonathan Brito. Alden Brutus.
Hello, graduating class of 2020. Congratulations. My name is Mr. Capra, and I'm the director of the retreat program here at McCarthy and a faculty member. Now tonight, I want to talk to you guys about the atmosphere of our school. Now, seniors, you guys know the layout of our campus really well, but have you ever noticed that the chapel is in the center of our campus? Maybe you have, maybe you haven't. However, the reason for this is because it's the center of our Catholic identity and culture. And for us, that's what truly defines us as a school, and it embellishes our atmosphere. With that being said, many of you have partaken in our campus ministry program, whether it was serving as a Eucharist minister at our Mass, singing in the liturgical choir at our Mass as well. Maybe you led a retreat or attended a retreat at Cedar Creek Camp, and all of you did service hours in our community and you helped your neighbors. Whatever contribution you made left a lasting imprint on our school, our atmosphere, and our culture. And to that, we are so grateful. Now, I can define what our atmosphere is all day. However, how does that resonate with you as a person and who you are moving forward? Many of you have attended our retreat program here at the school, whether it was ninth grade, Pieta retreat, or you went on a bus to Cedar Creek Camp in Tampa, Florida, and you attended Antioch or Transfiguration. With that being said, our retreat program was threefold. Number one, it was to improve your self-confidence. Number two, it was to establish new friendships, new relationships that hopefully were lifelong lasting. Number three, the most important, was to strengthen your faith and your foundation with God. Now, where does this leave you as a graduating senior? Unfortunately, a couple months ago, we had to cancel our Pentecost retreat, our senior retreat, which many of you were about to attend. And the question that I always pose on the opening of that retreat is, how are you going to carry your Catholic identity and your faith with you when you go off to college? It might seem difficult. It's different. And right now you're at a transition period in your life, right? However, the coronavirus has kind of hit pause on your life. You kind of sat there and kind of questioned what college is all about. You've had a lot of time to think. And unfortunately, also in the last couple of weeks, you've had a lot of events canceled and opportunities taken away. And I'm sorry for that. And it's not fair. However, you have two ways of thinking about this. Option A, you can focus on the negativity and you can let that define your high school career. Or option B, you can think about the culture and atmosphere that McCarthy has brought you and you can relish the new opportunities that are coming your way and be proud of who you are and the school you've attended. Now, I like to use the analogy of a tightrope. So you're at the starting point of this tightrope walk, right? And this is representative of your first step in the McCarthy hallway, right? It's brand new, sense of independence. And you're a little shaky at first, but as time progresses and time passes, you establish new relationships. You participate in Maverick games. You attend homecoming dances. You learn from the best teachers. And all of these relationships that you have forged have created a safety net, a foundation of faith underneath you. And so, as a human, we often fall and we lose our balance. But that foundation of faith has propelled you and catapulted you back on that wire. And because with that security, you knew that if you fell, you were okay. And that's the atmosphere that McCarthy creates. Now, at a certain point in time, that dorm room is going to shut and you're going to be staring at the walls on your first day of college. And you're going to obviously love these new opportunities that are going to be right in front of you. However, I want to challenge you to focus on the security that McCarthy has created in you, that sense of faith that is unspoken, because opportunities are going to come your way and they may not go as planned, like you've seen the last couple months with the coronavirus. However, don't let that falter you. Be resilient, have a strong sense of faith. It is who you are today that is a product of where you came from. So as you go out in the real world, remember how many people love you. And that love goes beyond any set of miles, any college campus, or any span of time. The love that makes your home lives in you. Once a Maverick, always a Maverick. And that will never change. Congratulations and the best of luck. Goodbye, seniors.
Nicholas Cackett. Antonio Calvo. Cade Cannon. Matias Capurro. Adrian Carballo. Alexander Cárdenas. Victoria Cardona. Francisco Carreras. Valentina Carrión. Jacob Carvajal. Alani Castillo. Alexa Castro. Cole Castro. Marie Antonia Catano. Shaim Celestine McGee. Maria Chavez. Christopher Chioka. Serena Chugani. Carl Cinquino. Aaron Coleman. Nadia Colon. Justin Cook. Danielle Cooney. Ryan Costello. Sarah Cox. Alberto Cuneo. Sophia Curry. Victoria D'Amico. Christine DeFinis. Luis Davalos. Meredith Davis. Abigail Day. Anthony de Blasio. Christian de Blasio.
Good afternoon, and congratulations to the class of 2020 from the College Advisement Office. As our school continues to grow, the quality of students that pass through our office continues to increase. This year, we have 8 students admitted to Ivy League institutions, 4 to Columbia, with 1 being a Quest Bridge full ride scholarship recipient, and 4 to Cornell, our biggest admit numbers for both of these colleges. We have the first student we believe in school history to be accepted and to attend California Institute of Technology. We have another student receiving a debt-free admissions to Tufts prestigious Newbards Scholars Program, and another admitted to Carnegie Mellon School of Computer Science, which is widely recognized as one of the first and best computer science programs in the world. Some of the other top school acceptances are the University of Chicago, Northwestern, Duke, Johns Hopkins, Notre Dame, Vanderbilt, Rice, Washington University in St. Louis, UCLA, Emory, the University of Michigan, Georgia Tech, New York University, the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill, the University of Florida, Boston College, and many more ranked in the top 50. Many of our students are not letting COVID-19 stop them from attending their out-of-state dream schools. We have over 50 students committed to pursuing their education nationally. They have worked so hard and deserve this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Even as our state schools have increased their admissions requirement, we still had a record number of acceptances. The class of 2020 is making it happen on every level. You all have worked so hard for 12 years, and we are blessed to have had the opportunity to work with each of you in pursuit of your next level of chapter in life. We are proud of each and every one of you in the class of 2020, and hope that you will come back and share all of your accomplishments with us. Whatever your path is after McCarthy, we wish you all the best in your future endeavors. COVID-19 does not define you or your class. Stay strong and continue to make a difference. Congratulations and God bless.
Taylor DeBrito. Nicholas Defendis. Nathaniel DeJuan. Gabriel de la Lama Sevilla. David Delgado. Giancarlo Delgado. Veronica Delgado. Sabrina del Rosario. Daniel DeMarin. Bruce Demos. Kayleanne Deneu. Catherine DePani. Alexa de Valdivia. Bianca Diaz. Jacqueline Diaz. Giovanni Diaz. John Diaz. Daniel Diego. Aiden Dow. Sonia Desa. Hannah Eldon. Sofia Enriquez. Alexander Espinosa. Justin Espinosa. Sean Fairhurst. Guillermo Farias. Emma Fosbach. Diego Fernandez. Gianna Fernandez. Grace Fernandez. Jonathan Fernandez. Melissa Fernandez. Miguel Fernandez. Stephanie Fernandez Blay. Alyssa Ferrer. Brianna Ferrer. Lauren Fielding. Jack Flam. Zachary Flanagan. Cynthia Fonseca. Luis Fraga. Ludiana Francis. Carly Fratina. Gabriel Fuentes. Manuel Fuentes. Gustavo Gallego.
Good evening, everyone. As a member of the academic committee, and also as a teacher, I've had the distinct privilege of working with the class of 2020 as they have pursued and achieved what I would certainly call academic excellence. And to the class of 2020, throughout your time at Archbishop McCarthy, but especially in these last 2 years, you have experienced, and I know many of you have embraced, what renowned psychologist Carol Dweck calls the power of yet. This simple yet profound notion that perseverance can overcome seemingly insurmountable challenges, that what is not yet achievable will still be possible tomorrow, this notion has led you to very impressive accomplishments. It has pushed you beyond your comfort zones to learn from temporary mistakes, to create alternative strategies, to develop new skills, and to always give your best effort, even when sometimes you are still learning what that best effort might be. And indeed, you have embraced some of the very real academic challenges. As Archbishop McCarthy's honors and AP programs expanded in recent years, more and more of you chose to take on very rigorous coursework. In many cases, you learned to juggle numerous college-level courses that required demanding end-of-year exams. Exams that, year after year, you have mastered in numbers well beyond what we see across the state or around the nation. And the same can be said for the class of 2020 as a whole. In truth, your PSAT, SAT, and ACT scores have routinely outperformed your peers, both statewide and nationally. What a remarkable achievement. And then, of course, there were the challenges of 2020 itself. Suddenly, you were thrust into a very different learning environment, even as your senior year was drawing to a close. You began to take all of your classes at home for the first time, to manage new learning schedules with new processes. Those of you taking AP courses learned that you would actually take your exams at home this year, that they would test nearly a year's worth of content in only 45 minutes. And what did you do? As always, you adapted. You persevered. You continued to demonstrate the grit and determination that has become so characteristic of this class. You met extraordinary times with extraordinary effort and with admirable resilience. So yes, you have mastered significant challenges during your time at Archbishop McCarthy, many of them academic, many of them otherwise. But if there is one thing that inspires me most about you, both as a class and as individuals, it is that you have faced all of these challenges courageously. And here we are. Not only are you graduating, but you are now moving on into what I know will be an amazing future. So in many ways, the best is certainly yet to come. On the other hand, as you take this momentous step forward today, yet is very much now, and you are ready. Godspeed, class of 2020.
Kevin Gamboa. Lucas Gandarias. Josh Gapusan. Beatriz Garcia. Nicholas Garcia. Sofia Garcia. Samantha Gersak. Sarathi Ghosh. Natalie Gill. William Goleman. Jarrett Gomez. Angeli Gomez Caldenidi. Sebastian Gonzalez. Valeria Gonzalez. Zachary Gonzalez. Eduardo Grabiel. Alexis Green. Ashley Green. Marianne Griffin. Maria Gudino Quahonte. Sebastian Guillen. Anthony Gutierrez. Ethan Gutierrez. Zayden Hadid. Matthew Harrow. Kelly Hastings. Maria Lucia Heenan. Darren Henry. Alicia Hernandez. Adriana Herrera. Isabella Herrera. Jillian Hightower. Zachary Hummel. Erica Honsey. Omar Hoyos. Florian Huck. Trevor Hyde. Isabella Jackson. Katarina Jarek. Monica Jean. Natalia Jimenez. Joshua Joaquim.
Good evening. On February 28th, the girls' soccer team defeated Pontevedra by a score of 2-0 to win Archbishop McCarthy's first state soccer title. About 2 weeks later, the world turned upside down, making soccer and all other athletics seem not so important anymore. Today, we are here to celebrate the entire class of 2020 on their graduation. I am here specifically to tell you about a special group of girls led by 12 seniors that made history this year. This year's accomplishments didn't happen overnight. As a matter of fact, it was 10 years in the making. We've always had a very good soccer program, but usually in the shadow of two other extremely successful local teams. We can compete with them on a regular basis, but to beat them was a totally different story. That all started to change in 2016, when this senior class were freshmen. We were young and we took our lumps against the powerhouses their freshman year, but there was something different about them. We knew it, and more importantly, our competition knew it. So what was different? How were they special?
We've always had talented players, and this year was no different. We actually may have had one of the most talented teams we've ever had, but that's not why we won it all. Every team that makes it to the state Final Four are talented. We found that out in 2018 when we made it to the state finals, state semifinals against Estero and lost a heartbreaker 5-4. We learned more the following year when we reached the state championship for the first time ever. We went into the game undefeated and nationally ranked. Unfortunately, Montverde Academy was also undefeated, nationally ranked, and internationally stacked. We lost a 1-0 in a very respectable game against the undisputed best high school team in the country. So we were 0-2 at states and losing a few great players each season. However, we had the experience now that there was no substitute for. Our girls could have taken these heartbreaking losses the last 2 years and given up. However, they all knew that that wasn't an option. It would go against everything our program has stood for the past 10 years, and it would have been disrespectful to all of our alumni that have paved the way for our current success. Our players know that our goal is not to win states. We believe there's a higher purpose for our team other than just winning soccer games. It's about working together as a team at everything we do, giving our best effort, dealing with the stresses of high school life together, and helping others in need. Our team knows that if they do all those things, the wins will come. Every eighth grader that comes that's interested in playing soccer at Archbishop McCarthy is told, if soccer is the only reason why you want to be a Maverick, this is probably the wrong team for you. It's about getting an excellent education, enjoying the atmosphere our school provides, and making a difference in the community. The soccer is just a bonus. It's the icing on the cake. The entire team believes in our values, and these 12 seniors have lived it for the past 4 years, setting an excellent example to their younger teammates. Our seniors have excelled in the classroom, in the community, and on the soccer field. Every single one of them have put the team's goals ahead of their own personal goals. A perfect example of this culture happened in the final minutes of the season. We're playing in the state championship game and winning 1-0 with about 15 minutes left in the game. Cassie Lawson was on the bench and ready to go back in. Now, Cassie is one of the best players in our program's history and has given and sacrificed as much as anyone to be in this game. The problem was, Cassie had a yellow card. So another yellow card would mean she's out of the game and we'd have to finish the state championship shorthanded. What would make matters even worse, if Pontevedra tied the game, we'd have to play the entire overtime with one less player than them. Although I knew what the correct decision was, I couldn't help but think to myself, how could I leave this girl on the bench in the final minutes of her career in the state championship game when she meant so much to our team? I approached her with my dilemma to get her thoughts. Without hesitation, Cassie said, don't put me in right now. This is way too important. Cassie, like the rest of her senior class, got it. She had completely bought in to being a part of something bigger than herself and proved it right to the very end. Fortunately, a few minutes later, Ileana Ramirez played a perfect cross to Lily Katz, who buried it in the back of the net and gave us the 2-0 lead and cushion we needed, that I needed, to allow Cassie back on the field for the final minutes of the game as the Lady Mavericks earned that ring. So was the championship season easy? Of course not. There were many obstacles to overcome. We pride ourselves about the true team effort and what every player has a role and every player matters. If we didn't, we would have not been prepared for what was about to come. The season started with UNC Charlotte commit and star center back Kelly Hastings missing the first month of the season with an injured foot. That meant Texas Rio Grande Valley commit Nadia Colon, Sofia Enriquez, Riley Schemmel, Kimmy Cover, Jessica Gonzalez, Ellie Acosta, Annalise Prieto, and Abby Davis would have to step up the defense in Kelly's absence. As expected, they did. Then, Seton Hall commit and starting central midfielder Riley Balzer tore her ACL, meaning her year was over. At the time, Riley was having the best season of her career and was the rock in the center of the field. That meant that Megan Circo, Adriana Duque, Daniela Fernandez, Gigi Galderiz, and freshmen's Jasmine Herrera and Kiana Riosorio would have to step up the game in Riley's absence. As expected, they did as well. This was especially important because midfielder and Babson commit Cassie Lawson was already playing in constant pain with an injury that lasted the entire season. Heading into the postseason, Sophia Goetz was our leading scorer for the last 2 seasons, but she was nursing a strained hamstring. 5 minutes into the district championship game, she completely tore it, meaning she was almost certainly out for the rest of the season. Meaning Ileana Ramirez, Natalia Perez, Lily Katz, Madison Burkhart, Bella Rocco, Aubrey Havens, Julia Moore, and UCF commit, and Miss Dairy Farmer Player of the Year, Jordan Pitter, would have to pick up the slack in the absence of Getz. However, there was another monkey wrench coming. Pitter cut her leg open in a freak accident at home and required 8 stitches. The average player would have certainly been out a few weeks at minimum. However, there's nothing average about Jordan Pitter. She didn't miss a minute of the rest of the season. A few days before our rematch with Pine Charter in the regional semifinal, the star of last year's state final, Issa Quintero, was accidentally hit in the head at practice, and her availability was now in serious doubt. We did not need to worry at all because Jordan Gifford and freshman Polona Pena were ready to go. This brings us to almost the very end, state semifinals. If we win it, we're back for another chance at that ring. Unfortunately, the under 20 World Cup qualifiers were also taking place. Nadia Colon had the honor of being called up to represent the Dominican Republic in the tournament. We made the adjustments, players stepped up as usual, and we won the game. Nadia flew home in time for the state final, and the rest is history. Over the last 4 years, these 12 seniors and their teammates have accomplished some of the following things. They've volunteered every year at the Life for Net Families Feeding Program every Thanksgiving. They've raised over $17,000 for sarcoma and pancreatic cancer charities. They've collected 4,800 pounds of food for the Pantry of Broward at every soccer camp during the summer. They've won the FHSAA Academic Team Championship. They've posted a record of 87 wins, 7 losses, and 10 ties. They've won 2 district championships, 3 regional championships, and 1 state championship. 5 of them will be playing college soccer next year. Riley Balzer, Nadia Colon, Sophia Enriquez, Kelly Hastings, Cassandra Lawson, Natalia Perez, Jordan Pitter, Ileana Ramirez, Megan Circo, Riley Schemmel, Emma Alfonso, and Lauren Alvarino. You have left your mark on Archbishop McCarthy High School and our soccer program. Every single one of you have made an impact to our success on and off the field. You were the first senior class to win your last soccer game. You have left some pretty big shoes to fill, but with the leadership that you provided, I know the girls are up for it. On behalf of Coach Wayne, Christine, Nikki, and Mr. Ho, we are all very proud of you and love you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
James Jones. Jordan Jones. Yasmin Judith. Emily Juriga. Jessica Kalen. Diego Karam. Giancarlo Cates. Megan Q. Rebecca Kerr. Sarah Naus. Varsha Cody. Colin Krings. Yadessa Lacayo. Connor Lacey. Michael Lambert. Ricardo Lenaro. Arturo Lara. Anthony La Rosa. Noah Larson. Cassandra Lawson. Caleb Lemon. Karel Lemonier. Daniela Leonard. Justin Lilly. Ashley Linares. Raymond Lindo. Christopher Linter. Keandre Little. Lauren Yerena. Victoria Lontop. Gabriela Llorente. Anthony Long. Gabriel Lopez. Alexandra Lugo. Mauricio Luna. Ian Lynch. Alejandro Machado. Diego Machado. Alejandro Manjares.
Alex Maladriaga.
Juan Pablo Marin. Cindy Marquez. Tatiana Marquez. Ryan Morali. Nicholas Martin. Vasai Martin. Abigail Martinez. Ayana Martinez.
Late February marked the beginning of what was expected to be a great spring athletic season for Archbishop McCarthy. All teams were off to an amazing start. The baseball team had just beaten the number 2 ranked team in the nation. The lacrosse team had taken a 12-3 victory over Cooper City. The men's and women's tennis teams had both boasted stats already that ensured they would all make it to the postseason. Girls Beach was marked to head back to states for the third year in a row. The track teams had already seen personal and team best times. The seniors on the flag football team had done an amazing job of preparing the underclassmen for the upcoming season. The girls lacrosse team had already boasted a better record than last year's season. The men's weightlifting team had won the Best of Broward tournament. The men's volleyball team had won their preseason tournament and were well on their way to their state championship. And the softball team had beaten American Heritage for the first time in 8 years. On March 12th, we got word that we might be shutting down for a few weeks. Coaches began to scramble. Some were able to get in another match, another game. Some got a senior night in. And the weightlifting team had to have their first online match. We were told we'd probably be shut down to the end of spring break. April 20th came and went. We were then told May 1st, which was perfect. All the teams would be able to have their district and regional tournaments, and those that were slated to go to states would have their moments. A few days later, Governor DeSantis announced that school campuses would remain closed for the rest of the year. That was followed by the heartbreaking news from the FHSAA that none of us wanted to hear. The spring seasons had come to an end. For those of you that know me, you know there are no wins and losses. Every athletic contest is a life lesson. And those lessons learned well help us to evolve into the best version of us that we can become. Your season was cut short, but you gained some of the most important life lessons. You have seen how fragile life is. You have learned to reconnect with the people that love you the most, your families. You have learned not to take the people that you see on a daily basis in the gym or on the court for granted. And you have learned once again during your high school career that although you are young, you can and do make a difference in this world. As an athlete, you have learned that you must continue to work hard each day to your full potential and beyond. You see, the games were canceled, but preparation wasn't canceled. Practicing your skill has not been canceled. Speed and agility training has not been canceled. Studying the sport you love has not been canceled. And having a great attitude has not been canceled. You will play again, but you'll play with a new appreciation for that game you love. You will play not only for the pure joy of accomplishments, but for everything the game can teach you about yourself. That feeling of belonging to a group endeavoring to do their best, and for the challenge of working harder than you ever have. Some of you will play for fun, and others will play as college athletes. No matter where life takes you, you take with you the memories of all the accomplishments you've made these past 4 years. On behalf of the spring sports coaches, I thank our players. You have made a difference in our lives. You have shown your love of the game, your dedication, your hard work, and your ability to meet challenges head on, your triumphs, and the lessons that you have learned to those that will follow in the years to come. And they, because of you, will too love the game. Congratulations, seniors. Remember, you are resilient, you are Mavericks, and you are the class of 2020.
Christopher Martinez. Janina Martinez. Jamie Matarrazzo. Blaine McBride. Shannon McGuire. Austin McLean. Alexandra McNamee. Mallory May. Robert Mendez. Ivan Mendoza. Kaylee Mendoza. Andrea Mérida. Kristen Mestre. John Metzger. Michelle Miguez. Natalia Mijares. Geika Milfort. Brianna Mizrahi. David Mizrahi. Anthony Modafari. Geralda Mondestin. Victoria Montes. Kevin Montoya. Mason Moore. Claudia Morales. Daniel Morales. Edelise Morales. Nicole Morejon. Michelle Moreno. Nicholas Moreno. Renzo Moreno. Brianna Moreno Alvarenga. Giovanni Muscarella. Gianfranco Musso. Jasmine Nathaniel Anderson. Idalis Navarro. Judlin Nelson. Hannah Newberry. Andrew Nguyen. Christopher Nicot. Christian Noble. Anna Nunez. Yanel Nunez. Martin Ogbimi. Catherine Ong. Daryl Ortiz. Emily Ortiz. Omosiwa Oyadiran. Gabriel Pachas. Gabrielle Pagano. William Pearman. Miguel Palacios. Alex Palmer. Daniel Pardo. Andres Perret. Juliana Patalano. Jason Paul. Shelby Paul. Nicholas Petterzini. Franco Peirano. Isabella Pena.
Throughout our campus, you will find artists filling our halls with their works. We have the Maverick Theater, filled with actors reciting lines for their next show, the Maverick Sound Marching Band tuning their instruments, the drumline creating beats, the liturgical choir singing melodies, the Spanish Music Club strumming their guitar and singing along,
Then we have our artistic creators working hard in Ms. Hansen's art studio. Ms. Santilli guiding our digital artists. We're also surrounded by the yearbook photographers capturing moments for us to treasure for years to come. Let's not forget about the creative energy in the MAV News broadcasting room. The arts surround us, fill us up, and entertain us each day on campus. We are blessed to be surrounded by such talent. Now I'd like to move into something I call the art of being a maverick. The art of being a maverick is something I've been blessed to see for the past 10 years. When students use their talents to create moments and memories. Seniors, class of 2020, you've created masterpieces throughout your 4 years. These will never be forgotten. Over the 4 years at McCarthy, our students learn how to give. They learn how to grow into giving their time, talent, or treasure to others through their hard work in various clubs, societies, and fundraisers. In learning how to give, you have learned that it spreads so much joy and hope for those who receive the gift, as well as for you in giving. It blesses your heart and your soul. You've used your unique talents to create moments within the 4As that will never be forgotten. You've made your mark in this school through dedication to various clubs, sports ministries, and most importantly, all your friendships over the 4 years. In this time, Mavericks, you've done so much. In the past 4 years, you've also contributed to, and now this year, led the Link Crew Movie Night and Carnival event, which has now reached a collective effort of almost $100,000 in donations through the years. Mavericks, you did this. It's gone to 4 different honorees, and they have felt the love of the Maverick spirit. This year was Jakey's story, and the Duque family felt so blessed when they received your gift. You took the time to gather donations, create games, find prizes, make decorations, and so much more. All the clubs united. Although movie night was canceled, the energy and hard work that was put in was not forgotten. The family was honored with the gifts and the 14,000 plus donation that your dedication brought to this family. You did it, Mavericks. You did that. You took the time to help another. Now I know this time has been taken from you, and this is very hard to go through, but you have to remember to keep your heads up, stay strong, lean on God, and look back upon all the times you had, all the moments you were able to create, the friendships made, the games played or attended, the competitions you mastered, the dances, the events, the plays you watched, the silly dress-up days you did with your best friends, the pep rallies you hollered at, and the retreats you grew from, and so much more, Mavericks. You have those to look back upon. We are so proud of you, class of 2020, and we can't wait to see what you keep creating with your gifts and talents.
Corina Penna. Madeline Pereira. Alejandro Perez. Ángel Perez. Carolina Perez. Emily Perez. Isabella Perez. Natalia Perez. Victoria Petter. Miguel Pichardo. Angelie Pierre. Luc Moise Pierre. Natalie Pierre. Jordan Pitter. Alberto Pla. Tamika Polis. Christian Pommels. Kayla Powers. Kimberly Puente. Daniel Quintana. Rhonda Ragabir. Sierra Rea. Dominique Ramil. Eliana Ramirez. Manuela Ramirez. Maria Ramon. Jacqueline Rao. Jessica Redmond. Ana Rementeria. Michael Repas. Gabriela Ray. Ariana Reyes. Jake Rivero. Jack Rivera. Daniela Roa. Kaylin Rodriguez. Bianca Rodriguez. Madison Rojas. Amber Romero. Alexander Rosleon. Sofia Rocco. Timothy Ruggiero. Julian Ruiz. Mia Ruiz. Brandon Sadowski. Joshua St. Ange. Curvins St. Prue. Jessica Salazar. Lauren Salcedo. Danielle Sanchez. Madison Sanjurjo. Michael Santiago. Juliana Santoro. Riley Schmel. Marissa Schur. Michaela Scott. Megan Circle. Lucas Sarah. Valerie Servideo. Emma Sheehan.
To my robotics seniors, you didn't think you were going to get to leave without me saying goodbye to you, did you? It's hard to believe, but some of you have been with our program for 5 or 6 years already, as you started in middle school with our summer camp. At that time, Maverick Robotics was just beginning. However, during these past 4 years, you have helped Maverick Robotics to grow into the largest and most successful robotics program in the state. Each of you has played a role in that success. After the incredible state championship this year, I know many of you were looking forward to traveling to Louisville for the World Championship, especially for some of you, as it was going to be your first time attending. Unfortunately, things didn't work out the way we had planned. However, I choose instead to focus on the incredible legacy that you are leaving behind now that you are graduating. Here are some highlights of your time with Maverick Robotics. In your 4 years, you have won multiple local, regional, and state tournament championships, excellence awards, design awards, and really every honor that can be awarded at a VEX event. In fact, I don't think any of you even know a robotics tournament where the name Maverick Robotics wasn't called during the awards ceremony. You've been part of 3 state championships during your 4 years. In 2020, you qualified an astonishing 6 teams to the state tournament, the most of any VEX program in the state of Florida. In fact, this year's state championship witnessed the most dominant performance by any program in the history of VEX in Florida. Not only did you win the state title for the 3rd straight year, you had Maverick teams in every semifinal match and Maverick teams competing against each other in the finals, with 4 of our teams qualifying for the World Championship, a record for Florida Robotics. What else have you been up to? In 2018, you started our Robotics Honor Society chapter, which was the first in the state of Florida. You also gave back. You began our mentoring program with St. Mark, even qualifying them for the high school state championship, not the middle school. So technically, we really had 7 teams there this year. Some of you served as counselors for our summer camp, helping to get the next generation of students excited about robotics. You provided countless hours of mentoring and training for Broward County Public School teachers and students, including helping them run multiple Broward County VEX events. This Lenten season, you packed dozens of Easter baskets and stuffed over 1,200 eggs for those in need. In the end, you put in thousands of hours in the robotics room. What are you going to do with all that free time now? I know the year didn't end quite the way you had hoped, but let me assure you, your legacy as part of the history of Maverick Robotics is secure. You joined when the program was still in its infancy, And now you graduate knowing that you have been an integral part of building Maverick Robotics into a nationally and globally recognized program. You've really done it all. But most importantly, during your time as seniors, you have helped to prepare the next generation of Maverick Robotics team members. They will carry on now in your absence. Take pride in knowing that they are ready. Their successes will be your successes. As you graduate, you may be leaving the Maverick Robotics room, but you will never leave Maverick Robotics.
Catherine Sierra. Samantha Sigler. Grace Sims. Makina Scrobar. Benjamin Smith. Myla Smith. Shane Smith. Sean Smith. Carlos Solares. Bennett Summer. Emerson Speziali. Kyle Spraka. Caitlin Suarez. Christini Tanjung. Angelo Taranto. Miguel Taveras. Michael Tavermina. Federico Tellez. Angelina Tata. Hayden Thompson. Owen Timoney. Alyssa Tomei. Jesus Doral. Kayla Torres. Matias Torres. Sabrina Torres. Xenia Torres. Annabelle Torres Fernandez. Nicholas Torres Moncayo. Bradley Trask. Gabriella Twombly. Daniel Tribaldos. Alejandro Valdez. Victoria Valerio. Nicholas Vallejo. Jacob Van Burskirk. Matthew Van Burskirk. Matthew Vasquez. Ryan Velez. Isabella Vigil. Grace Villavasanis. Peyton Vines. Chloe Y. Sophia Weintraub. Evan Welch. Reese Willenborg. Bethany Williams. Nicole Womberg. Nicole Yamin. Emily Yave. Alyssa Yiki. Maria Yokoyama. Stephen Young. Gabriel Zaragoza. Veronica Zasloff. Kelly Zipazuka. Matthew Zuniga.
Congratulations to the Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School Class of 2020. As a symbol of the unity of the class, please move your tassels from the right to the left.
must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strain. Without a name for so long, a beautiful smile to hide the pain. I could fly high
I now welcome Father Jadot to close our ceremony in prayer. Thank you.
Please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God, in his love and his wisdom, may he watch over you, may he bless you with good health, with wisdom, with peace and intelligence. May he bless your families and continue to provide for you all. May God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.